Hello guys, I'm Jitendra Chaurasia. Welcome back to my channel, The Office Guys Tutorials. Unlike my previous tutorial videos, this video is going to be slightly different. In this video, I'll be taking you through the process of how I found a 90s slide. It's not exactly 90s, but it's a pretty old design, and how I converted it into a modern looking design. I found this slide over authorstream.com, and this PowerPoint slide is for some academic purpose. It looks like that. And it relates to some environmental issues, which starts with a question. Actually, it should be agenda. It starts with the questions. There are few points here. The site chosen for the environmental discussion is Hampi. And next, you have they are telling about the historical significance of this place, and a couple of more historical significances again. And then they are discussing about the threatening factors which is affecting the place, which is Hampi, and they are telling about the remedy, like how the government agencies are now taking preventive measurements to save these kind of places. This again, and couple of photo gallery, and that's all. So when I was just looking at this presentation, I just found a couple of things that came to my mind. Is first of all the color theme. It's quite old, and if you notice, one more thing that we don't have. These people don't include any margin on the sides, so when you're presenting over presenter or a projector, it doesn't look good to have such things here. Coming up to the third slide, what I don't like about here is the improper space utilization. And the next slide, again, lot of text. It's really a lot of text. Again, lot of text again, same once again, and the sixth slide also. Okay, threatening factors looks fine, but still can be improved. Then again, okay. So keeping this couple of points into my mind, I have created my own version, which you might have already seen during the intro. So let me just show you my thought when I change this to a newer look. So let me just put up things side by side so that I can explain you better. So I'm keeping it like this. So coming up to the slide one, I'll just zoom in here so that you can see it properly. So I'll just come to slide one. So what I did here, what's my thought is, I want to have some sort of image which shows me something like green color or environmental issues. Since the original slides belongs to environmental issues, I thought to keep something related to environment. So the next concern comes, where to find this kind of resources? So there is a website, it's called unsplash.com, and you can go there and just type in environment or something like that, and you may find the images. You can see the source images here, and I have taken this image, and I download this image. And for your information, all the images on this website are free to download and use, so you'll not be come across any copyright issues. Now when I downloaded this image, I kept it here, and what I did is, let me just quickly show you. I took a rectangle, so let me just take a new slide. I'll just quickly tell you, this video is not intended for that, but let me just quickly tell you. So I made a shape first like this. I drawn a rectangle like this, and again one more rectangle I have drawn. So I just duplicate this, reduce its width, and just rotate it around somewhere like 45 degrees, and extend this, and I'll just keep it to this corner, and I will extend it until it covers the entire thing. So I'll just select this and this, come to format option, merge shapes, and I'll click subtract. Now I'll come to insert tab, insert picture, this device, and you can see I have all the images available here. So this is the image that I have used. Click insert, and here we have the image. I'll just quickly enlarge this image to match the width, and press Ctrl C on the keyboard or Ctrl X, so you can cut also, not an issue. Right click, format shape, fill, and come to picture or texture fill, and just click on clipboard. You'll notice that you have that picture here. And next option, don't forget to check this tile picture as a texture. So right now you might notice that this picture looks a little compressed towards center, so I'll just click this, and you can see now this picture is on actual scale. If you want to move this picture a little bit here and there, I'll suggest to play with this offset X and Y value. So this is how I made this slide, the first slide. and just I kept this environmental texture here, and I use a modern, some modern looking font. For this presentation, I have used Montserrat. So that's what I did for the first presentation, and this is just simple rectangle. This is a simple rectangle I just placed over here. So there's nothing big deal there. Okay, coming to the next slide. I'll come back to that. So next slide is called question. First of all, I don't know what is the meaning of writing question here, like Q-U-E. They can write entire thing question or something like that. So what I thought, instead of using question or some any other term, I thought like agenda. So this clearly indicates what is the agenda here. And you can notice that they have filled the entire slide and too big font to have. So I always like white spaces to be there. White spaces are always equal. They're as equal as your content. So you should always make some white content as if possible. And another important aspect that you might notice, that so when I design this slide, the vertical spacing is maintained is very well. In fact, if I don't use any bullet point also, this slide even looks better. You can see the full screen preview. So you can see you have an agenda slide without even bullet point also, it looks better. So there is no bullet point, but still the text readability is still fine. So this is what my another thought that I have put here. Next slide. Okay. Now here they're introducing the place of their interest. So how I made this slide is, instead of writing a big heading line here, like the site chosen by us is Humpy, I just made it very clean. Site of interest. Now it's very clean that in that slide you're going to discuss about the site of your interest, which is Humpy. And the way they have written is underlined or so many things. I have used something called a rule of contrast. So I have created enough contrast between the text or any other thing. You can see there is no other black color on entire slide in this in my design. So the Humpy is really clear and it stands apart from everything. Another important aspect they have missed here is called they have to at least mention the state or the country. For example, if the same title is read by somebody outside, they won't be able to understand where is Humpy actually is. If you're trading online, that's fine, but I would always recommend to be as clear as you can. So Humpy, Karnataka, India. Then in a similar fashion, I found some images online. I went to again Unsplash and I just typed here Humpy, and I found a couple of good images over there. So you can see this image I have taken here, and a couple of more images I have taken there. But let me just come back to my slide. And what I did is I used rectangular shape to cover them up, and format shape. You can see I have added some transparency to just add a feel to the four images. If I remove this, they all look almost the same. That don't give the feeling to that slide. So I just added some color, but when you see it on the full screen, it looks very nice. So how I have given this animation is, I'll just quickly show you. Come to animation tab, animation pane. So you can see the rectangle, these are the pictures. So I've given the animation type is flying to this picture and flying from the right. So the images are coming from right. And after that, these rectangular boxes are also flying in at the same time. And after that, rectangle boxes are wiping up. Okay, so they are wiping up. So I have added another effect called wipe up. If you have any doubt, you can let me know through the comment box. I will definitely get back to you as soon as possible. So let me just show you once again. So boxes are coming and now wipe up. So that's how I created this slide. I hope you like this slide too. Coming up to the next slide, historical significance. Now this is a slide where I just want to put some emphasis. Now you can see that they have written a lot of text. It's not a lot, even if I have some word to say more than a lot, it's the same. So you can see they've clearly written the city of Vijayanagara, commonly known as Humpy, is located on the banks of Tungabhadra. I don't find a meaning of writing everything, because anyway, when you're presenting somewhere, you can say these things verbally. So what I did is actually, my thought is like this. What I did, I added a map of that so that now visually it's very clear that a Tungabhadra river is going nearby it. So even though the second line here, if I can delete also, that is not going to make any much difference because it is visually clear that it's on the bank of Tungabhadra River, a city of Vijayanagara Empire. And you might notice that the text is grayed out. So what I did is I just added some animation effect. So like when you click point by point, that will be like, it's like a reveal effect. So the text will appear. Now how I did this effect is, you have something called option called font color. When you choose that font color option, it'll ask you which color you want to reveal. So you just fix a starting color. For example, let's say I want the initial color is this yellow, and I'll come to animation and I want red to be there. Okay, when I press any key on the keyboard, if you see now, you can see it's changing to red. So this is how I used this template. And one animation that you may notice here is on the map. Okay, just I'll show you. So you see the map here, the one box comes with that. So what I have done is just I have created a rectangular box of the same size as of the map. And this map I have just taken a screenshot from Google Maps. So I have taken this and I have added an animation to that. You can see it's a line animation from here to here. So that is the other thing that adds a little bit taste to the slide. Coming up to the next slide. Okay, so they still added lot of things. I read, but I didn't find any meaning of putting it there. But I took a couple of points from there. Okay, for example, it's the bank of Tungabhadra River. So I added that also. And like between 14 to 16 centuries, okay, it was the wealthiest. So you're showing the significance, right? So it has to be there. It is known for it has some religious association, so definitely more people will be coming. So I thought that it has a local and international tourism as well. Other things related to Ramayana and all, I don't find any meaning to put all this history particularly, because it takes the entire scope of the presentation out of way. Now coming to threatening factors, so how I just took this into factor is, they have made two slides. So the first threatening factor is called urbanization and unplanned development. Now one thing that you have to realize here is, the text used by this guy, I don't know the name, but it's SK something. Now you can notice that there is no difference between the text and the heading, if you notice here. Okay, there is no difference between. So that is what you have to always think. Your heading should be different from your body. Either you can differentiate it by color or by contrast. So I'll just show you how I have accounted for this thing. So you can see I have taken same font, same color, but I have taken a bolder version. Okay, this is called Montserrat Black and this is Montserrat Only. So I have taken a two family of the same font, which helps me to create a difference in contrast. So this is how I have incorporated this thing. And coming up to another aspect of this slide is, there is a lot of waste of space here. You can see this space is waste, this space is waste. And after that, they are making another slide, which the second threat to that is scone quarrying and ramped population, pollution. Now what I thought is, this slide is totally empty. I don't know what they're going to speak here, or I really don't know, but I thought, why can't we just make it one slide? So that's why my thought here. So first is urbanization and second is environmental threats. Now if I show you on the screen or the full screen view, you'll notice that I have added some sort of a reveal effect. So I have did the same thing. I have taken a rectangle with rounded edges and I just placed it over this, and I have given a wipeout animation to that, so that it looks like you are giving some like clarity to that you are talking about urbanization now. And now I'm talking about environmental threats. So this is what I thought for this particular slide. Coming up to the next one is called the steps taken to preserve geological heritage. Now this slide, once again, it's full of text. Presentation is not about giving so much text to your audience. Definitely, audience, if you make a slide like this, your audience is going to die for sure. Not die, but at least they will sleep for sure. So I worked on this slide to bring something really close to what is written here. So the Hampi World Heritage Area Management, I read this line and I realized that what they are doing is, they are doing identification of unauthorized construction. And I just placed the same text over here. Second thing is they have mentioned the stone quarrying. I don't know how I really don't know how to pronounce this, but I think stone quarrying. Okay, so the second point is they're trying to say is permanent ban on stone quarrying. So I just found some couple of related image, and once again I have used the same platform. I think for this I have written something like construction worker. I'm not sure, but something like this I have written, and I found this image. Yes, you can see it's there. And for this image I think I have written something like crane, you can type. I'm not pretty much sure, but something like this, something with this kind of word I have written, and I found this image on unsplash.com. okay, anyway, I'm not able to find the same image, but you can just type in some other keyword. Excavation, I think I typed. Yeah, I remember. I think it's excavation, and I found this image. Yeah, it's there. That's how I put my thought on this particular slide. Now coming up to next slide. Now they have kept some photo gallery. Okay, I really don't understand what is the meaning of putting the photo gallery there, because I don't know how they're presenting there. But I thought, okay, there one thing is they missed really is there is no thank you slide. At least for your audience to appreciate their time, we should always have some thank you slide. So if you see my thank you slide here, I've added an animation effect there, thank you, and I've just given us some message. Now the purpose, even though it's for a course, maybe it's it looks like it's an English course where students are presenting, but even though when it comes to presentation skills, it's always important that at the end of slide you should deliver your audience what was the motive of your presentation. It's clear that maybe the student presentation was made keeping in mind that they are presenting for English course, but at a major scale, you see, they are trying to put something, some heritage sites that are in danger. They are trying to put it forward to people. That's why I thought there should be some message there so that they have a clear view of the presentation. So I wrote, let's make this world a beautiful place to live. And one thing that you notice, the slide, that it looks like it is coming behind this rocky mountain. So how I did this, let me quickly show you. So what I did is, you can see there are two images of this, and what I did is I just removed the background of this. Okay, I removed the background of this image. In case you don't know, let me just quickly tell you how to do that. So like this, you can take any image. Let me just create a duplicate, and I'll place this back here. Select this image, come to format option, remove background, and which area you want to keep, just keep on clicking that area. You just keep on clicking the area that you are looking for, and I don't want this area. So like this, you can just keep, and just you click keep changes, and just make sure that you place it right at the same place that so that it looks like it's a part of that image. So you can just quickly zoom in. You need to spend a little bit of time to get it accurate. So you can see I have spent a decent amount of time to get it accurate, but the process remains same. It's all how you give time. The more time you spend, the better will be the result. So that's all, guys, for this video. I hope my thoughts on like how you can take any of your old slide and you can change it to a new modern looking slide design. Thank you, guys, for watching this video. I hope you like this tutorial, and don't forget to give me a like. Do subscribe to my channel for any next video. Thank you.